Hello, welcome to another episode of Vibes History. My name is Tim Collins, and today we're going to be talking about the master himself, Milt Jackson. This is one of any number of amazing solos he played throughout his career, but this one in particular I really like because it's an unusual trio setting, which he did not record very often. This is from a 1975 trio record with masters Ray Brown and Joe Pass called The Big Three, and this is their rendition of Moonglow. So let's get into the tune. I hope you enjoy it. Jackson, so much amazing musicality between these three gentlemen. First of all, the push and pull between the time feel of all the musicians. Playing a groove is not metronomic. Playing a groove is about being in agreement with the members of the band, and everybody needs to constantly be listening to where the center of the beat is, right? There are moments where Milt Jackson plays double time, and he gets a little bit on top, and then at the same time, Ray Brown is laying it back, and Joe Pass will just kind of go right down the middle. What ends up happening is you get this real natural push and pull, but at the end of the day, the groove is right there, and that's kind of what makes people start to bob their heads. If it were metronomic and everything were perfect and quantized, it would not be grooving. All right, now I want to talk about some specific moments in this. The intro. Check this intro by Joe Pass. It's so subtle. Ray Brown plays, and then Joe Pass plays. And then the next one. Let's just check some of the melodic embellishments that Milt plays when playing a melody. Right there. So he, at the end of the melody, he fills in with a blues riff. Mm-hmm. Something like that. More blues. Oh, the way that he it's a scale, but it's also a glissando. That's just a straight up G7 bebop riff. Milt is the first guy to take the language of Dizzy Gillespie and Charlie Parker and put it on the vibraphone. That's why he's the master. Boom, 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 boom. So right there, it's a B-flat 7 chord, and he's turning it into a B-flat 7 with a flat 13 or a sharp 5. And a flat 9. So again, on that C7, he does that a lot. This is similar to what Cal Jader was doing in the last video that I made, where you have a C7 chord, and he's taking the 5th, the flat 5th, the 4, to the 3, and that's the shape that he kind of keeps adding in. And you're going to hear that in the solos, too. That's the sharp 9, flat 9, so B flat 7, and he's altering it so that it's cadencing on the 5th of the E flat. Double time. Listen, Joe Pass laying it down. Ooh, Milt Jackson going all heavy metal. Again, there's your C7 with a C13 with a sharp 11. I love that line. I play it myself. I ripped it off from this solo. Sometimes, why would you do anything other than play the blues? He starts at the top, he skips the 5th, goes straight down to the flatted 5th. It comes out of that double time, so it's like such great phrasing. Here's the bridge. Again, that's a really cool line. Check this line out. Again, B flat altered. There it is again. That's like what I call a blues exclamation point. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back for more. I'll see you real soon in the next one. Thank you.